So what I have here is a non-functional mercury thermometer, and this time I want to recover a mercury on there like that. Mercury have a many different uses and well known as a gold and silver extraction for how many years. So we remove the cover first. And I had prepared our panning and fill with water. So let's start. So first thing to do here is to cut the tail under the water, so that the mercury here, when you cut here, is if there is mercury from the tube line, is running to the and out. Be sure to cut this part under the water. We need extra care. Very simple. We remove that. Yeah. And I think done cutting the tail, so let's start the break the mercury here side under the water. Very quick and easy. Be sure that no more mercury remain in the tube line. The next, this one has a mercury until to there. There's a mercury here. That's why we cut the tail. Very simple. We clean up later on. really short but large. So continue working here. Very nice thermometer, as you can see. Yeah, large amount of mercury. Cleaning here to ensure that this remaining mercury from the tube line, we remove that by doing like that, and it's totally clean, no more mercury in the line. Okay, let's remove that. This one also has remained few amounts of mercury. Now clearing is done. 100% no more mercury remain in the tube line. So we proceed for isolation. So what I have prepared to isolate here is a 4 liter of empty gallon. We isolate this one. We remove all the glass here, and now we remove our glass, break lug glass here, just like that. All the glass particle here has added to our gallon and also our now it's time to close, and this one will stuck forever in my stock room. Now I had prepared filter paper here to capture our mercury, so I decant water first. Very dense metal, so I think no more left. So let's take on our scale how much mercury we got on 13 pieces of mercury thermometer. Zero, zero. So 27.18. Yeah. So thank you so much for watching and God bless everyone. And shall put it in a plastic and ready for storage.